Joining us now, three of Kamala Harris's closest friends, her Alpha Kappa Alpha sorority sisters. Welcome Jill Lewis, she's there in Dallas. Lorri Saddler is in the ATL. And Monique Poydras is in Washington, D.C. And you got, you got a little backup there. I see, Monique.
Yeah.
Some more sores that are
That's
there.
That's right.
Lorri, let me begin with you. What was that moment like personally for you when your close friend walks out on that stage with Mary J. Blige playing? What was that moment for you?
Wow. It was absolutely amazing. Absolutely amazing. And what made it even more special was to share that moment with my three daughters. I actually have three daughters. The oldest is a graduate of Clark Atlanta University, and I'm very proud to say is also our sorority sister. My middle daughter is currently a student at Howard University, and actually the silver lining of the pandemic was that she was at home in Georgia voting with us as a family for her first voting opportunity. And then my youngest daughter is a high school student, so experiencing it with them was really amazing, and seeing their reaction. And they're well aware of the history and the struggles that we've had in this country, but what they know is that we had a black president and now a black female vice president. And this totally shapes their reality. And for them, what they said was they realized there are no limits for them. And that was what was really amazing.
I'm sure that they feel that way. Full disclosure, my mother, Howard University, AKA Lucy Marion Roberts, she was one of your sorors back in the day in 1946 when she graduated, showing a picture of her right there. So I fully know what your motto is: scholarship, sisterhood, and service to the organization. So Monique, tell me, what was it about Kamala Harris, even back then, that destined her to be in the position of leadership that she's in?
You know, it's just her drive and her characteristics as a leader. And as a public servant, you know, it's no surprise, you know, her journey. And it's just, again, such an amazing time and chapter for America, because they are about to get a woman who worked so hard and is going to work so hard for the country alongside President-elect Joe Biden. It's amazing. So, you know, reflecting on our time at Howard University, we're talking about someone who was dedicated to social justice issues, to protesting apartheid. You know, the activities that she was involved in clearly, you know, just transcend where she's at today. And it's just overwhelming and just so amazing. And we're so proud of Kamala.
And Jill, I would imagine, or not imagine, I heard that she was unflappable. There was a time when you all were rushing out the doors because it was initiation. Can you share a story there for us, Jill?
Oh, sure. So the thing that always characterized Kamala was grace under fire, grace under pressure. If you can imagine being with 38 women and needing to get places, do things, have deliverables, and she was even keel throughout. And we used to give her some ribbing because many times we were wearing these black coats that people have seen pictures of her in, and they'd be in a gigantic pile. Imagine 38 black coats in a pile. She was able to carefully pick out hers and put it on and be ready to go.
Unflappable even then. Ladies, thank you so much. And forgive me for not wearing pink. I should have known, either pink or green. But I do have on purple. My dad was a Q Dog at Howard, so I do have on the purple for Q.
Okay.
But thank you so much for letting us get to know the vice president-elect just a little bit better. You take care. Well, hey there, GMA fans. Robin Roberts here. Thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Lots of great stuff here. So go on, click the subscribe button right over here to get more of awesome videos and content from GMA every day, anytime. We thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the morning on GMA.